Rebot, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies for Bedford TV. Today I'm going to be discussing See You Yesterday, a movie that was released to Netflix on May 17th of this year. And I'll tell you what, I really, really liked it. And as always on The Review, I will be offering my recommended viewing guide. I will be recommending that you go and see it. If it is available in theaters, I'll say stay home and stream it. If it's available to stream now, and I think you'll enjoy it just as much from the comfort of your own screen. And I will recommend that you skip it if I didn't enjoy it, and I don't think that you will either. And that was not the case with See You Yesterday. Before I get into the specifics of this movie, I love time travel movies. I am very, very open to different sorts of time travel. I just want to exist in the world of that movie while I'm watching it. I'm certainly willing to take giant leaps of faith. If you tell me that it works, I am in. I'm not going to be questioning it while it happens. And before I get going, just some other excellent time travel movies that I think that you would love. About Time, Kate and Leopold. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to stop there because I want you to watch those movies. Check them out. They're both available to stream now. You're going to have to pay a little bit of money, but I promise that it's worth it. When you have seen About Time and Kate and Leopold and See You Yesterday, my email is johnnythestylist@gmail.com. I want to talk about them. I loved those movies, and this movie is super cool. If you have watched The Review before, you know that I really appreciate a short movie. If a movie is 90 minutes or less, I am going to watch it. And I'll tell you what, See You Yesterday is 86 tight minutes. It is that good. Like I said, came out on May 17th. It's still new. People haven't seen it very much yet. You can be on the cusp of it. It actually doesn't have a standard rating. It is rated TV-MA, which I was surprised about because different Netflix releases either get the TV rating system or the movie rating system. This is a feature-length movie, so I was surprised that it had the TV rating. I looked into it. I couldn't find an explanation of why that was, and I do think that it's weird. This movie is an expanded story from a short that came out in 2017 of the same name from the same writer and director, Stefan Bristol. I think that he did an excellent job of creating a full and rich world, especially in a short period of time, but truly immediately. From the very beginning of See You Yesterday, you realize that you are in an awesomely full world, great colors, absolutely shot on location. It's set in modern day Brooklyn. And I think that this movie is incredibly spoilerable. I'm not going to talk too much more about the plot other than it is the story of CJ and Sebastian, played by Eden Duncan Smith and Dante Crishlo. They are brilliant students, and it is set at the beginning of summer. And CJ and Sebastian, for the science fair, invent time travel, and about 80 more minutes of movie ensues, and I loved it. And there are some performances in this movie that hit incredibly hard. A performer who goes by the name of Astro played Calvin. He was incredible. Jonathan Neves played Eduardo, and that is a full character that really, really feels like a high schooler that I could sympathize with. And typically, I avoid all major spoilers, but I want you to watch this movie, so I'm going to give this little bit away. Michael J. Fox has a cameo in this movie, and you haven't seen it till you see it, so you should watch it. I loved this movie. I think that you will, too. It has the real potential to be one of my favorite movies of the year. You should absolutely stream See You Yesterday. I loved it, and I think that you will, too. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.